Hello students, this is my second video. Now we are going to find the inverse of a matrix A. Whatever we have learned till now is to be used for finding the inverse of matrix A. Here we have a 3x3 matrix whose elements are 2 1 1 1 0 1 0 2 -1. So first step to find the inverse of a matrix is write this matrix A as A is equal to I3A. Here I3 means a unit matrix whose order is same as the order of the given matrix, which is 3x3. So we write this matrix A as I3A. Okay, we have put the value of A matrix and I as the identity matrix. So we write the value of identity matrix, which is 1 0 0 0 1 0 0 0 1, and A as it is. Here we are finding the inverse of matrix A by using row transformation. So whatever the transformation or operation we are using, same is to be applied on this identity matrix, because whenever we are finding inverse using row transformation, we apply that transformation to the prefactor only. Remember, only to the prefactor. To make this A matrix as the identity matrix, we have to make this element as 1. We have many methods to find to make this element as 1. We can interchange these two rows or use any other transformation to make this element as 1. So here we are applying transformation row 1 minus row 2, because 2 minus 1 is 1. So we are applying this transformation. So the new matrix is, when we minus 2 minus 1, this becomes 1. Okay, and 1 minus 0, this remains as 1. 1 minus 1, so it becomes 0 now. And other two rows, these two rows remain same. Similarly, in this matrix, we apply operation to this row and other two remain same. Same operation means row 1 minus row 2. So it becomes 1, 0 minus 1, it becomes minus 1, 0 minus 0 is 0. Okay, next work is to make this element, means second row, first element. This element as 0, again we have many methods. We can interchange these two rows or make this element 0 with the help of this element. So we are applying transformation row 2 minus row 1. So this new matrix is, here we are applying transformation to the second row. So first row and the third row remain same. I am writing it as it is. Same in this matrix. First row and the third row remain same. Only changes occur in second row. 1 minus 1. This becomes 0. We write, here we are applying on row 2. So all the changes occur in the second row. 1 minus 1. This becomes 0. 0 minus 1. It becomes minus 1. 1 minus 0 is 1. Same transformation here. 0 minus 1 is minus 1. 1 minus 1 and this minus. 1 minus minus 1. It becomes 2. 0 0. So it remains 0. And third row remains same. A as it is. Till end we have to write this A as it is. Okay, after this, the next task is to make this element as 1. Remember, this sequence remember the sequence which we follow to make this as a identity matrix is 1 0 0 1 0, and this as 1, this as 1, and other two elements is 0. Okay, so next task is to make this element as 1. Here it is -1, so multiply this row by -1, this become plus. So we are applying this transformation row to multiply by -1. So new matrix is here the transformation is applied to the second row only. So all the changes occur in only in the second row, other rest of the two rows remain same. So the first row remains same, second, third row remains same. Changes in second row is this become +1 and this is -1. Similarly, we have second row which is +1, ye minus 2 becomes -2, 0, and other two rows remain same. Okay, after making this element as 1, next task is to make this as 0. We take the help of second row. 2 becomes 0 when 2 is subtracted by 2. So we apply operation row 3 minus 2 times row 2. So only changes occur only in the third row, not in the first row or in the second row, only in the third row. So first row as it is, second row as it is, third row. This, when we multiply this row as by 2 and subtract from this, it becomes 0, remains same. This is 1, 2 multiply by 2 and subtract from this, this it becomes 0. Similarly, -2. And this -1. -2 multiply by this -1. It become +2. +2 minus from this -1. It is equal to +1. Okay. Same operation has to be applied on this row also. Very carefully we have to do the calculation, as this is 1. Put this value here. Row 3 is 0. 0 minus 2 into 1. It is -2. Similarly, this is -4 and 1. Okay. After this, and next task is to make this element as 1. It is already 1. So, we use this 1 to make other element as 0. We have to make this matrix as an identity matrix. To make this element 0, we take the help of this row, this element. Okay, this is -1, this is +1. If we subtract these two rows, this becomes 0. Okay, so next operation depends upon how to make this as an identity matrix. So we apply operation R2 plus R3. We are going to plus these two rows. 0 remain, 0 plus 0 is 0 here, and 0 plus 1 is 1, plus 1, minus 1, plus 1, this becomes 0. Okay, and this here we write this first row as it is, third row as it is, only changes occur in the second row. 1 minus 2, minus 1, minus 2 plus 4 is plus 2, 0 plus 1 is 1, A as it is. Okay, now if we look carefully, the only element which has to be 0 is this. So we take the help of row 2 to make this element 0. We subtract these two rows, so we apply operation on R1 minus R2. So this element becomes 0, because 0 plus 0, 1 minus 0 is 1, 1 minus 1 is 0, 0 minus 0 is 0. Other two rows remain same, and the same transformation is to be applied here also. Minus 1, 1 minus, and this minus become plus, and this becomes 2. Okay, and minus 1 minus 2, this becomes minus 3. Similarly, 0 minus 1 is minus 1. Other two remain same. Now this matrix becomes an identity matrix. So we write I, and this is a new matrix. We named it as some B matrix, this A as it is. If the product of two matrix is equal to identity matrix, then they are the inverse of each other. So B is the inverse of the matrix A, and its value is the same. 2 minus 3 minus 1, minus 1 2 1, minus 2 4 1. Okay, since it is very very important topic hai, so we have to check that this answer is correct or not. So we multiply two matrix A and A inverse. A inverse is this value. A already given in the question is the same A. We multiply these two matrix. If the result of these two matrix is equal to I, then our answer is correct, and we have find the correct answer. So students, this is how we find the inverse of a matrix. It is very important topic. So practice it thoroughly and try to solve more questions from this topic. Okay, bye-bye.